honestly, I'm kind of glad I didn't make a video earlier because this project has been through really weird life, and now I get to talk about all of it. When it first began back in 2020, or at least when it first became public, it wasn't even as the project that most people seem to know it as, the AMD CUDA project. It began as reported on by Phoronix, ZLUDA, drop in open source CUDA support for Intel Xe / UHD graphics. Built off of Intel's One API Level 0, which is the most marketing speak of marketing speak names. From the Intel documentation, the objective of Intel One API Level 0 application programming interface is to provide direct-to-metal interfaces to offload accelerated devices. Its programming interface can be tailored to any device needs and can be adapted to support a broader set of language features such as function pointers, virtual functions, unified memory, and I/O capabilities. Basically, it's low-level hardware access, which for something like this is kind of what you're looking for. Allowing for unmodified CUDA applications to run on Intel GPUs with near-native performance. And the unmodified part is very much the important part. Not needing to add in some additional API, taking something that already exists, and then running it on this hardware. With a giant grain of salt, ZLUDA doesn't yet support all CUDA functionality, but enough for the likes of Geekbench for demonstration purposes. In the future, it might also be possible to extend ZLUDA to run atop AMD's HIP interfaces as an alternative to Intel Level 0. Michael Larrabell had absolutely no idea how correct he was in this assessment. 4 years later, in February of 2024, there was another article from Phoronix. AMD quietly funded a drop-in CUDA implementation built on ROCm. It's now open source. While there have been efforts by AMD over the years to make it easy to port codebases targeting NVIDIA's CUDA API to run atop HIP / ROCm, it still requires work on the part of the developers. And nobody wants to do the work because, look, NVIDIA is just the bigger market for workloads just generally involving GPUs. The tooling has improved, such as with HPF5 to help in auto-generating, but it isn't a simple, instant, and guaranteed solution, especially if striving for optimal performance. Over the past 2 years, AMD has been quietly funding an effort to bring binary compatibility so that many NVIDIA CUDA applications could run atop AMD's ROCm stack at the library level, a drop-in replacement without the need to adapt source code. In practice, for many real-world workloads, it's a solution for end users to run CUDA-enabled software without any developer intervention. Now, whilst it had been in development for a couple of years, it was still fairly early days, it was still experimental, there was still a lot of work to be done. However, with the benchmarks that already existed, it was looking fairly promising. Why did that not load to the page? Whatever. Obviously, the green cards are NVIDIA, red cards are AMD. And yes, it is obviously going to be slower in a lot of cases. Pretty much every case, it is going to be slower. But it was very competitive, and in cases of really lazy additions of Radeon HIP, actually could be faster, in this case with a 7900 XTX, 2 seconds faster using this solution. But obviously you weren't going to go out and replace all of your NVIDIA cards with AMD cards, at least in its current state. But if you're someone who is a home user and you want to make use of CUDA workloads, or you're some research lab that has a bunch of AMD GPUs lying around, or, I don't know, for whatever other reason, you get your hands on a bunch of AMD GPUs, this was competitive. And again, it was not perfect, it still needed a lot of work, but this was the worst it was ever going to be. It was only going to get faster from here, and eventually, yes, it's not going to, like, generate performance out of nowhere and make GPUs faster than they can be. But if you need CUDA, and you're not like a data center, you're just some random person who wants to have some CUDA, I don't know, machine learning stuff, something like that, you could legitimately consider buying an AMD GPU. At least that's what we thought for a couple of months until August of 2024, where another article was published. Open source AMD GPU implementation of CUDA, ZLUDA, has been taken down. Taken down not from an NVIDIA legal challenge, but rather AMD. You know, the people that funded the project from the start, or at least from the start of the AMD part. The agreement was that if slash when the contract ended, the ZLUDA code would be open sourced. That's what happened back in February, but now the code has been retracted from the official public GitHub repository, with this being in the README at the time. Important. What happened? The code that was previously here has been taken down at AMD's request. The code was released with AMD's approval through an email. AMD's legal department now says it's not legally binding, hence the rollback. Before anyone asks, I have received no legal threats or any communication from NVIDIA, because this is something well protected under law. There was this big legal case with Oracle versus Google, you know, the Java lawsuit that most of you have probably heard of. What now? At this point, one more hostile corporation does not make much difference. I plan to rebuild ZLUDA starting from the pre-AMD codebase. Funding for the project is coming along, and I hope to be able to share the details in the coming weeks. It will have a different scope, and certain features will not come back. I wanted it to be a surprise, but one of those features was support of NVIDIA GameWorks. I got it working in Batman Arkham Knight, but I never finished it. And now that code will never see the light of day. You don't really hear the term NVIDIA GameWorks anymore. They still use it for the actual repo for the tech, but this is where things like PhysX, OptiX, Visual Effects, and a bunch of other NVIDIA game tech exists. I distinctly remember when GameWorks was a giant talking point when PhysX was first coming out, and it was like, ooh, look at how great these liquid physics are. Look, if you open this thing, the water all flows out. Wow, it looks great. But everyone was really, really annoyed because this was NVIDIA proprietary tech. You needed an NVIDIA GPU. You could technically try to run it on AMD, but it ran absolutely terribly. But back to the main point. The main reason I didn't cover ZLUDA earlier when this actually happened is there just wasn't really anything to say on it. The author was not speaking. The author did not want to add any context here. And we could have theorized about why AMD did this, whether it was some miscommunication and it was never supposed to go open source anyway, whether there was some internal legal trouble, maybe they just didn't want to deal with NVIDIA, maybe they thought there would be an issue if this went open source. I don't know why it happened. Over on the repo, someone asked, can you share the email? And they checked, they were not allowed to do so. The only thing they were willing to confirm is the issue of sender and email content is ultimately meaningless here. AMD Legal acknowledges that it was sent, but they believe no matter its consent, it is not legally binding. So, very likely someone higher in the chain said, hey, don't do that. And they're like, okay, don't do that. And what are you gonna do? Take AMD to court? Good luck with that. Now, 2 weeks ago, someone asked a very simple question. Is there a current state of the project? I am a bit confused on where exactly the project is compared to the past, because nothing had really happened in the repo since everything was taken down. And then they made an announcement. I plan to have an announcement about current state and project goals next week. Stay tuned. 3 days ago, we found out exactly what that announcement was. ZLUDA's third life. ZLUDA is back. For the last few months, I've been trying to find a commercial organization that would guarantee the continued development of the project. I am happy to announce that I have found one that is not only willing to fund further development, but also has an excellent vision for the future of ZLUDA. I share their long-term vision, and I can't wait to talk more about it. We don't want to discuss everything just yet, but for now, we know that we want to make ZLUDA better. If you think ZLUDA is a cool project, we have even cooler projects in the works. Development has begun, and as soon as we have something to share, we will. What I can talk about now is the current state and the direction of ZLUDA itself. Now, as it currently stands, the company, the organization, the billionaire that wants to fund this is not publicly known. So, it could be anyone. It could be NVIDIA. That would be funny. It could be AMD, which actually would be funnier. Or it could be one of these companies like Tiny Corp that is building these machine learning focus boxes and wants something like this to be available. I need a new mic stand. We have no idea. The code has been rolled back to the pre-AMD state, and I've been working furiously on improving the code base. I've been writing the improved PTX parser I always wanted and laid the groundwork for the rebuild. Currently, some very simple synthetic GPU test programs can run on an AMD GPU, but we are not yet at the point where ZLUDA can support a full application. For a couple of months of work, that's really impressive. So where is it going? The year of the rebuild. The ultimate goal is to bring new ZLUDA to a similar state as before the rollback in 1 year, Q3 2025. Similar state is very subjective here. I don't have precise criteria, but an application of similar complexity should work just as well. Not every pre-rollback application will be supported again due to new priorities. Focus on machine learning. This is what it should be. I know some people, machine learning bad, machine learning bad. If we're talking CUDA, right now, this is one of the major workloads. In the past, ZLUDA mainly focused on professional creator workloads. This meant focusing on applications like Arnold Render, Blender, 3DF Zephyr, etc. We even had a working prototype of GameWorks. While all of these workloads are important, extremely satisfying to have running, machine learning workloads are in much higher demand. We are targeting for LLM.c, Llama.cpp, PyTorch, TensorFlow, and others. Retracing is gone. This is related to the previous point. Not many people realized it, but ZLUDA had an OptiX implementation. While ZLUDA OptiX only supported just a handful of OptiX demos and simple Arnold scenes, it required a lot of code and broke all the time. Considering how underpowered it was and how much maintenance it required, it is a feature that is unlikely to ever come back. GPU support. The new ZLUDA will be built to support multiple GPU architectures. The mainline development will happen on AMD GPUs, as that's what most of our users have. Still, I do realize there's a lot of interest in other GPUs, e.g. Intel. This is sort of the only other one that people would consider. Yes, there are other GPUs out there, but if we're talking what GPUs most people have and what GPUs you probably want to run CUDA on, NVIDIA has native support. You're doing AMD. The list of remaining is very short. I don't think the EG is very required there. And hopefully this will lead to more code contributors and new backends. Pre-rollback ZLUDA stayed on ROCm 5, mainly because I did not want to retest all the version-specific workarounds. Since we're starting with a clean slate, AMD backend will target ROCm 6.1+. More modest set of supported AMD GPUs. We will only support RDNA 1 and newer non-server AMD GPUs. Supporting pre-RDNA 1 and server GPU architectures was an additional support burden and never worked as well as RDNA 1 Plus GPUs due to the Wavefront 64 configuration they use. Note that this applies to current architectures. AMD recently announced the merger of RDNA and CDNA into a single architecture, UDNA. Marketing terms. I have high hopes for this new architecture and expect it to simplify porting CUDA to HIP and to bring ZLUDA to server GPUs. Downgraded Windows support. Windows will still work and be supported, it'll just be less user-friendly, ZLUDA.exe will be gone. If you ask me, if you're messing with something like ZLUDA, you're well outside the realm of user-friendly activities. So, in my opinion, it doesn't really matter. Windows developers have invented several imaginative ways to load CUDA into a process. ZLUDA.exe has tried to support all of them, and even succeeded. Most of the time. As a user, you have to fashion some other way to load ZLUDA into the target process. Usually copying these ZLUDA binaries to the application is sufficient. We will provide ready-to-download Windows binaries. And the last one here is just make code less bad. Which is a good goal for anyone to have. ZLUDA will remain open source. This means that any features that are not part of the plan are fair game if someone steps up and submits a pull request. Personally, I think there is no better way to express your undying love for your Radeon 7 than to add support for it in ZLUDA. And of course, if there are any of the features that he said, I don't particularly want to do and you want to step up as a maintainer, I have absolutely no doubt he would be willing to let you do so. But what do you think? Who do you think stepped up and supported the project? Where do you think it's going to go? Are you excited about this happening? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and one day AMD GPUs will be slightly better idea to buy.